Hello my dear student, today we will be discussing about the application of adsorption. So here there are many applications on adsorption. So first one is gas mask. Second one, removal of colored material. Removal of colored material from solution. Third one, production of high vacuum. Fourth one, controlling humidity. Fifth one, suppression of inert or noble gases. Sixth one, curing diseases. First one is gas mask. So here the gas mask containing charcoal or mixture of many adsorbent. It is used to adsorb all the poisonous or toxic gas from air. So here these gas masks are mainly used by miners during mining, because in mining the poisonous gas like carbon monoxide and methane are produced in the atmosphere of coal mining. The poisonous gases like carbon monoxide, methane are absorbed by charcoal to give fresh air for breathing. So, gas mask for air is in path. Activated charcoal. So, activated charcoal is in charcoal ಅನ್ನ ನಾವು ಹೀಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೂಡಲೇ ಅಲ್ಲಿನ ಕತ್ತಿ ಆ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಗೆ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವು ಪೋರಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರೆ ಹೋಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಸೊ ಹೋಲ್ ಫಾರ್ಮೇಷನ್ ಆಗೋದ್ರೆ ನಾವೇನ್ತೀವಿ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಕ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತೇವೆ. ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್. ವೆನ್ ವಿ ಹೀಟಿಂಗ್ ದ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೋರಸ್ ಆರ್ ಹೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಬ್ಟೇನ್. ಸೊ ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಟೆಡ್ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್. ಈ ಆಕ್ಟಿವೇಟ್ ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾವ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಪಾಯ್ಸನಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ನ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂತಾವ. ಹೌದಾ? ಸೊ ಪಾಯ್ಸನಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂತಾವ. ಯೂಸ್ವಲಿ ಈ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ನ ಎಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ನ ಕೋಲ್ ಮೈನ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ ಈ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೇವೆ. ಸೊ ಎದಕ್ಕಪ್ಪ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕೋಲ್ ಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಆಗೋ ಟೈಮ್ ನಾಗ ಪಾಯ್ಸನಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸಸ್ ಯಾವ ಇರ್ತಾವು? ಕಾರ್ಬನ್ ಮೊನಾಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಮತ್ತು ಮೀಥೇನ್. ಸೊ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾವು. ಸೊ ಆ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಕ್ಕಂತ ಪಾಯ್ಸನಸ್ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಸೊ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್ ಮಾಸ್ಕ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊತೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಏನ್ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ? ಫ್ರೆಶ್ ಏರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಬ್ರೀದಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ removal of colored material from solution. So consider the substance like sugar solution, juice or vegetable oil. These all are colored due to presence of impurities. When these solutions contact with adsorbent. So mainly charcoal. So here this charcoal adsorb all color materials. So we get colorless solution. So second one, anything? Removal of colored material from solution. So colored materials yaradavu? Sugar solution irbodu, juice irbodu, athwa vegetable oil irbodu. Ivella colored yak agirthavu andre idrolige enadavu impurities adavu. So impurities irodrinda ivella henga adavappa andre colored solution agavu. So namage enagabekagitti aa colored solution olagirtha impurities remove madabekagitti. So adanna en maadthidre adsorbent yavudu use madthru? Charcoal use madthru. So idakka ee ella solution gana charcoal addition maadipa andre ಚಾರ್ಕೋಲ್ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀವಿ ಎಲ್ಲಾ ಕಲರ್ಡ್ ಇಂಪ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ ತನ್ನ ಕಡೆ ತಗೊಂತೆ. ಅವ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಥವಾ ಕಲರ್ಲೆಸ್ ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಸಿಗುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆಫ್ ಅಡ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ಷನ್. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಮೂವಿಂಗ್ third one, production of high vacuum. So what do you mean by vacuum? Vacuum andre enu? Nirvata prashna. Nirvata prashna andre enu? Gaadi irantakkanta prashna ayi kerithiru. Vacuum andre enu? Nirvata prashna kerithiru. So here adsorption use the production of high vacuum. So here consider container consists of number of gas. Consists of number of gas. So these gas are removed by vacuum pump. These gases are removed by vacuum pump. But there remains some gases in this container. But this container containing some amount of gases. So here these amount of gases are removed by adding charcoal. By adding charcoal. When we add charcoal, this charcoal absorbs all the gases present in the container. It makes high vacuum. It makes high vacuum. So now, third one is production of high vacuum. So now, what do we do? One container is gases. So our gases are hanging around the pump. Vacuum pump is changing. So vacuum pump is removed. All gases are now being removed. So amount of gas container is so all this is what charcoal add mark. Charcoal add mark upon the charcoal air mark, little amount of gas in air mark, absorb mark. So absorb mark will create a vacuum created. And then guard is like that, but this created. So this is the third application of adsorption. So next, fourth one, controlling humidity. So here, usually silica. And alumina. So here, usually silica and alumina is absorb moisture in air. It absorb moisture in air. So here, for example, many electrical machines are stored or kept in box. That box containing small amount of white sachet or white packet. That white packet is nothing but that is silica. It absorbs all the moisture present in the box. So, nothing point in controlling humidity. How the humidity and rain tevasha. Tevasha means that control water. Then control water means absorb water. Then absorb water means absorb into. What is the condition? Garden means that moisture absorb water. How the so now what? Electronic machines better to so electronic machines are better to for atom box of packet. How the other thing to small amount of white. Packet it is so white white packet is found under silica. That is called same move. Why is that? Because absorb. So here fourth one controlling humidity. So next one fifth one suppression of inert gases. So already we know what is inert. Inert gases. Inert gases means what? Inert means what? Noble gases. So here so it is used to suppression of inert gases. So here these inert gases absorbed by adsorbent in different temperature. So here consider container containing different noble gases or inert gases. If you add charcoal and charcoal, this charcoal adsorbs all the noble gases. After some time it removes, then heat this charcoal. We get different noble gases at different temperature. So here, fifth one is suppression of inert gases. So one container is that. Or again, is noble gases. So that our noble gases, if that container is that, what is absorbent. Absorbent. What do? Activated charcoal. Na addition. What is that? Activated charcoal. Here, what is container के तकनता ये ला नोबल के असर absorb मर पड़े थे उधर absorb मर तकनता charcoal नो heat मरे कुले और नमी elimination आते हुए तो ये ला नोबल के असर को elimination आते हुए तो with different temperature. So this is suppression of inert gases. So last one curing diseases. So here number of medicines are used to cure diseases. Most probably the fungal infections are cured by using medicines. So this is the curing disease. So curing disease. यूजली फंगल इनफेक्शन आगे डॉक्टर मेडिसिन बरतर फ्लूको फ्लूकोनेज़ल इज यूज्ड टू ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ दैट फंगल इन्फेक्शन बाय अप्लाइंग ऑन द फंगल सो हियर फ्लूकोनेज़ल ना यूज मॉडल फंगल इन्फेक्शन या जगह आगे फॉर एग्जांपल स्किन में फंगल इन्फेक्शन आगे फ्लूकोनेज़ल ना यूज मॉडल सो हियर दिस फ्लूकोनेज़ल जेल इज एक्ट एज एड्सॉर्बेंट एंड स्किन इज एक्ट एज एड्सॉर्बेंट सो देयरफॉर दिस इज द यूजेस टू क्यूर डिजीज सो लास्ट वन Fourth rotation process. Last one, fourth rotation. So last one, fourth rotation process. So here, the sulfide ore is mixed with pine oil and water. The air is passed through this mixture. So here, the ore particles, means the sulfide ore particles, are adsorbed on fog. These four are present at the surface. It can be removed. So now, last concept in the four fluorination process. Here, sulfide ore is pine oil and water mix. So mix water again. Air pass water. So air pass water from air formation. Fourth formation. So fourth one is good formation. So our fourth one is here. The sulfide ore signal. So these are the applications of adsorption. Next, we move towards catalyst. So, what do you mean by catalyst? So, here, the catalyst is a substance which changes the rate of or velocity of reaction without changing their chemical composition and mass. So, this is called as catalyst. So, here, catalyst means it is a chemical substance. This chemical substance changes the rate or velocity of reaction without changing their chemical composition and mass. So, no. Catalyst is entry don't substance. Okay. So, ये मार्टिन पान होता है. Rate of reaction ना change मार. ऐसे नू मार्ट बोलो, कड़ी मिनु मार. Okay. So, rate of reaction change मार देते. हमारे ये मार देते. इतने द chemical composition आगे mass आगे change आएंगे ला. Reaction ना involve इतनो. तब द chemical composition नू मतलब mass change आएंगे ला. जितना हम कहते हो catalyst करेंगे. So here, consider example, manufacture of ammonia by Haber process. So here, nitrogen is combined with hydrogen in presence of iron to form ammonia. So here, iron is act as catalyst, means iron, it changes the rate of reaction. So this is called as catalyst. So next we move towards the catalysis. So here catalysis means the phenomena of changes rate or velocity of reaction by adding catalyst. So this is called as catalysis. So here catalysis means the phenomena of changes the phenomena of changes rate or velocity of reaction by adding catalyst. So this is called as catalysis. So catalysis is named called those phenomena. So here at the rate of reaction change agate. So rock change agate upon the catalyst addition martirla. So again at the change agate. This na ee process na yen karibodu catalysis an karibodu. Next we move towards the catalyzing. Promote. So here in catalytic reaction the activity of catalyst can be increased by adding small amount of substance. That small amount of substance is known as catalytic promoter. So consider an example. One mole of nitrogen is combined with 3 mole of hydrogen to form ammonia in presence of iron as catalyst and by using small amount of molybdenum. So here, this small amount of molybdenum, it increases the activity of catalyst iron. So here, this molybdenum, it is act as catalytic promoter. So now, catalytic promoter in part, catalytic reaction water, activity of catalyst activity, other chetovating and a hex model, bare one small amount of substance in a add mark. A small amount of substance in a yin carrying pound the catalytic promoter and carrying. So, example of commentary, so formation of ammonia. So, 1 mole of nitrogen, 3 mole of hydrogen could be pound the ammonia formation activity. So, yin is more than catalyst and iron and catalyst use more. Okay, iron catalyst again, I mean, use more than small amount of molybdenum use more than molybdenum in pound the promoter. So this is about the catalytic promoter. So next, we move towards the catalytic poison. So here, in catalytic reaction, the activity of catalyst can be decreased by adding small amount of substance. That small amount of substance is known as catalytic poison. So here, consider for example, manufacture of sulfuric acid by contact process. In this process, so arsenic oxide is as present as impurities. And this arsenic oxide decreases the activity of platinum. So here consider reaction. 2 mole of sulfur dioxide react with oxygen to form sulfur trioxide along with catalyst platinum. So here arsenic oxide is present as impurity. This arsenic oxide decreases activity of platinum. So therefore, this is arsenic oxide is considered as catalytic poison. So next, we move towards the types of catalysis. So here there are two types of catalysis. First one is homogeneous catalysis. Second one, heterogeneous catalysis. So first one, homogeneous catalysis. So here, so what I mean by homogeneous catalysis? So here, in catalytic reaction, if both reactant and catalyst are in same phase or same state, so this is called as homogeneous catalysis. So here, homogeneous catalysis means the catalytic reaction in which both reactant and catalyst are in same phase or same state. So this is called as homogeneous catalysis. So homogeneous catalysis under another. So on catalytic reaction order, reactant to mother catalyst to yellow same phase again or same state again. This can carry through homogeneous catalysis. For example, sulfur dioxide is oxidized with oxygen in presence of nitric oxide. So here, formation of 2 mole of sulfur trioxide. So here, this is the second step in the manufacture of sulfuric acid by contact process. So here, in this case, here sulfur dioxide and oxygen and catalyst nitric oxide. So here both reactant and catalyst are in same phase. So here sulfur dioxide also gaseous state, oxygen is also gaseous state, and nitric oxide is also gaseous state. So here both reactant and catalyst are in gaseous state. So therefore, this example belongs to homogeneous catalysis. So consider another example. For example, sucrose. So what do you mean by sucrose? Sucrose means it is a cane sugar. Formula C12H22-OLED. So here, this sucrose undergo hydrolysis. What do you mean by hydrolysis? When a compound react with water to form acid or base, or both acid or both base. So this is called as hydrolysis. So here, sucrose undergo hydrolysis in presence of dilute HCl or H2SO4. In presence of dilute HCl or H2SO4. So here, formation of glucose and fructose take place. Formation of glucose and fructose take place. So here, sucrose undergo hydrolysis in presence of HCl, dilute HCl or dilute H2SO4 to form glucose and fructose. So here, in this case, sucrose also in liquid state, HCl also in liquid state. Means here both reactant and catalyst HCl in same state or same phase. Therefore, this example also belongs to homogeneous catalysis. So consider another example, carbon monoxide undergo oxidation. Carbon monoxide undergo oxidation. So what do you mean by oxidation? Addition of oxygen. So this is called as oxidation. So here, carbon monoxide undergo oxidation in presence of nitric oxide, we get carbon dioxide. So in this case also, both reactant and catalyst in same phase. So here, these examples belongs to homogeneous catalysis. So here, homogeneous catalysis means in catalytical reaction, both reactant and catalyst are in same phase. So this is called as homogeneous catalysis. Second word, heterogeneous catalysis. So here, it is in catalytic reaction, both reactant and catalyst are in different phase. So this is called heterogeneous catalysis. So here, heterogeneous catalysis, reactant and catalyst in different phase or state. For example, number one, manufacture of ammonia by Haber process. So here, nitrogen combined with 3 mole of hydrogen to form ammonia in presence of iron as a catalyst. So here, in case of formation of ammonia, so nitrogen is gaseous state, hydrogen is gaseous state, but catalyst iron, it is in solid state. It means in this reaction, the reactant and catalyst are in different state. So therefore, this example belongs to heterogeneous catalysis. So next, second example, dehydrogenation of ethyl alcohol. Dehydrogenation of ethyl alcohol. So here, CH3CH2OH. So this is the formula of ethanol or ethyl alcohol. So here, dehydrogenation. So what do you mean by dehydrogenation? So dehydrogen means removal of hydrogen molecules. This is called as dehydrogenation. So here, ethyl alcohol undergo dehydrogenation in presence of nickel as a catalyst. So here, formation of CH3CO, acetaldehyde with hydrogen. So here, in this case, reactant ethyl alcohol, it is in liquid state, and nickel, it is in solid state. So therefore, this example also belongs to heterogeneous catalysis. So here, this is about the types of catalysis. So here, next assignment, first question, write the application of adsorption. Second one, define catalyst with example. Third one, define catalysis. Fourth one, define homogeneous catalysis with example. Fifth one, define heterogeneous catalysis with example. Dear student, watching this video, try to answer these questions. Thank you.